So in this video package, we shall be talking about financial accounting 1, and the topic we'll be discussing is partnership final account, video clip A. So when you finish with video clip A, you go to video clip B. After B, you go to video clip C. After C, you go to D. These video clips will keep coming until this topic is over. So video clip one, video clips lies within the range of 15 to 20 minutes until the topic is over. So keep downloading the videos and keep updating your notes. Make sure you have your calculator, have your earpiece to enjoy our tutorials very well. So we shall be talking about partnership final account in this package. The partnership final account, we have final account for sole traders. We have final account for partnership, we have it for companies, both public and private limited companies. So it is a law in accounting that at the end of a financial year, that a firm should present their final account, whether sole trader or partnership or company and so on and so forth. So we shall be talking about partnership account in this package. So prepare yourself, let's go inside the classroom right away. So partnership final account is account prepared by a partnership at the end of a given accounting period. Account that is prepared once a year until the accounting period is over. Or within the accounting period. So what we should be after now is what are the components, what are the steps, what are the stages in preparing a final account of a partnership account? What are the steps? What's the first thing you should do in preparation of this account? So the first thing you're going to do is to prepare the body of the trading account. That's the first account you prepare. Body of the trading account. Body of the trading account is a general account. In partnership, anytime you are working with partnership, be very careful with these two words I want to mention now. Number one is general and number two is specific. Separate these two things from your mind and you're going to be preparing this account very well. General and specific. When you talk about general, you're talking about those matters involving the general business entirely, the entire business. In fact, the partnership itself. Then we talk about specific, you're talking about partners, because there are two things in partnership, the partnership and the partners. The partners are the owners of the partnership. Then the partnership itself is the business. So whatever that concerns the partnership is talking about general. And whatever that concerns the individuals that owns the partnership, we're talking about specific. So this body of trading account you see here have nothing to do with specific matter. It doesn't concern the individual partners. It is applicable to the partnership as a whole. Number two is the body of the profit or loss. The body of the profit or loss. Account of the partnership. The body of the profit or loss account of the partnership is where all the expenses and income generated by the partnership within a given period will be recorded. Note, generated by the partnership as a whole. Partnership as a whole, not the individuals that own the partnership. So the body will comprise all the expenses made by the partnership within a given period of time and all the income generated. So at the end, we're going to be explaining these items one after the other. But know that whatever you are doing here now, the body of the profit or loss is information that relates to the partnership entirely. And the body of the trading account relates to the partnership entirely. And the third one should be talking about the body of the profit or loss, appropriation. The body of the profit or loss, appropriation. That is the third one. Appropriation in the sense that this one deals with special matters. This one is special. Special in the sense that it is where you record attributions of each partner. Now you're not talking about the partnership as a whole in this third one. You're talking about the partners now. You are being specific. General is talking about the general business, but specific is talking about the partners individually. So in the third stage of preparation or in preparation of final account is the body of profit or loss appropriation, where you record information that are directly attributed to the partners. Then after that, we'll talk about number four. Number four is the body of the capital account, of the partners. The body of the capital account of the partners. So this one is still a special item in relation to the partners individually. The body of the capital account of the partners. So this number four, which is the body of the capital account of the partners, can as well be called the statement of changes in equity. And most of the times it is prepared in columnar form, representing the each column represents the attribution of each partner in the business. So you can equally call it a statement of changes in equity, this number four. Then after that, we have the last stage in preparation of final account of a partnership, which is called the statement of financial position. The statement of financial position. So as you can see, there are five stages you need to undergo in preparing the final account of a partnership. The first one is the body of the trading account. Trading account is the general account of trading. Just the normal trading, you know, from your primary accounting, when you are preparing your normal trading profit or loss, normal opening stock, add purchases, add carriage inward, less closing stock, you get cost of goods sold, you compare the value with the sales, you get the gross profit. Just the same way, there's no difference. Pick the information that is just talking about the general business. Opening stock, normal thing you know. The same way you prepare your normal trading profit or loss, trading account in the primary account is what you're doing here. Then after that one, you prepare the profit or loss account, which is still the same thing. The general profit or loss is still the same thing with sole proprietorship, the way you prepare the sole proprietorship profit or loss. Where partnership account really comes in these stages of preparation is from the third one, where you prepare the profit or loss appropriation account, which is the one that deals with the partners individually. Then that is number three, number four, and number five. Number one and two of these accounts, you are conversant with it from your primary accounting. So I'll start developing this topic very well from this number three, the body of the profit or loss appropriation account. So that should be the area we are heading to right now. So we shall be talking about profit or loss appropriation account. The profit or loss appropriation. So here we are exactly talking about what are those things that the partners did individually which affects the profit of the business, either positively or negatively. So when the profit are affected negatively, we'll call it loss. We'll describe it as loss. But if the profit is affected positively, we'll describe it as profit. So what are those things that individual partners did that is directly affecting the partnership individually? So that is what we are talking about here under the appropriation account. And the motive behind this account is to ascertain the profit which the partners will share at the end of the year. So what is their share of profit, and how is share of profit calculated, and where is it calculated? All these things are being done under the profit or loss appropriation account. So the first we're going to do now is to list the content of this account. What and what can reflect in this account? Number one item that can come inside this account is interest on capital. Interest on capital is one of the items that will come inside this account. This interest on capital should be given in the question paper. It should be given in the examination. So if it is given to you, it normally come as a rate, as a percentage. They will give it to you as a percentage. And what it means is that you use the percentage to multiply the value of capital for each of the partner to get the interest on capital for each partner. But note one thing, if there is no interest on capital, when you are preparing final accounts of a partnership and there is no interest on capital, the rate is not given. Interest on capital, the rate is not given in the question paper. This computation must be done whether it is given in the question or not. The law says that if interest on capital rate is not given, that you should make use of 5%. So if they give you the rate, you use the rate. But if the rate is not given, use 5%. That's what the law is saying. So interest on capital is one of the basic items which should reflect in the appropriation account. Number two is commission. Commission to any partner. Commission to a partner. Commission to a partner. A partnership can give commission to a partner maybe for performing a specific task. The partnership just give a partner a commission for doing some particular job for the partnership. So when something like this is done, it will be reflected in the appropriation. Now be very careful when they give commission in a question as a general name, and when they say commission to A, where A is one of the partners. These are two different things. If you have commissions without telling you commission to A or B, then that means that the commission will go in the body of the profit or loss. But when you have commission and they mention the name of a partner attached to that commission, you don't reflect it in the body of the profit or loss. It will not come under the appropriation account because appropriation deals with individual partners privately. So commission directed to a partner A, B, C or something will appear here. That is what I'm talking about. Then number three, and secondly, if this commission is not given in a question, that means it is not given. You should just forget about it. You should just ignore it because it is not given. You forget it. There's no formula we use in calculating it, just like interest on capital. When interest on capital is not given to you, you make use of 5%. But this one, you just forget about it. Number three is salary to a partner. Salary to a partner. Most of the times, if a partner is an active partner, he will be entitled to some salary from the partnership because of being very much active in the partnership. So when something like that happens, in the question, you will see where they write salary to A or salary to B or salary to C or something. So when you see this kind of something, it will be attributed to the profit or loss appropriation. Salary to a specific partner. But when you see salaries standing on its own without being directed to anybody, that means that the salaries is a general matter. It will appear in the body of the profit or loss. Number four, drawings. Interest on drawings. Remember that I'm talking about those items that can appear in the body of profit or loss appropriation. Those items that can come inside this account. This is normal profit or loss of a partnership, but it deals with what the partners did individually, which tends to affect the profit of the partnership positively or negatively. So have interest on drawings. If you have interest on drawings in the question paper, you should reflect it. If it is not given, there is no formula we use in calculating it. Just ignore it or forget about it. But if it is given, you attribute it to profit or loss appropriation. Number five, interest on loan. Interest on loan to a partner. Interest on loan to a partner. Now, at times, a partner may be having some issues financially and may demand that the partnership should borrow money to him or her. In that case, if the partnership agreed to give her that loan, what it means is that the partner now should be owing the partnership, and any loan given out by a business attracts an interest. So, which means the partner of which the loan is given to will pay interest to the partnership, and the interest on loan will be given as a percentage. So when you have a question or your question paper, you check if you are giving the rate of interest on loan to any partner. Maybe the partnership borrow money to somebody, you will see it interest on loan to A, which means a partner. That interest on loan is directly applied to a partner. In that case, you bring it under appropriation. But if you see in a question interest on loan without giving you direction, or maybe they don't say A or B or something, then that interest on loan should reflect in the main body of the financial statement. That's the profit or loss. It shouldn't come under appropriation. Whatever that is coming under appropriation must be items that are directly affecting the partners individually where they are involved. Now, this interest on loan is in two ways. I'll bring you the next one as number six, as interest on loan from a partner. Interest on loan from a partner. From a partner. You see, this one said interest on loan to a partner, interest on loan from a partner. You see, a partnership business may be having financial issue and they needed money, and one of the partners who is buoyant enough can just borrow money to the partnership. In that case, the partnership is now owing the person. And if the partnership is now owing the person, you will see it in the question paper, interest on loan from A, interest on loan from B, which means that the partnership is owing the person. That particular interest on loan should reflect in the profit or loss appropriation account. So this is what we are saying. So these are the basic components which you always see under the appropriation account. You go through the question given to you, start for these items, use them to prepare appropriation account. Now, the next thing is, what are the effects of these items? There are six in number. I don't think at your level they will go beyond this. We have six items here. These six items, appropriation account of partnership is of two aspects. We have the profit side, we have the loss side. Some of these items affect the profit. Some of these items goes to the loss. So that what I'm trying to say is that some of them are positive to the profit and some of them are negative to the profit. So these two things need to be demarcated, because at the end, we have to ascertain the profit which all of them will share. So we can equally just say number seven, share of profit. It will still come inside this account. Share of profit is another component that we are trying to forget. It's supposed to appear inside this account, share of profit. And this share of profit is the difference between the profit and the loss, or the expenses and income, depending on the items involved here. So these items, one after the other, number one to seven, will affect the profit or positively or negatively. And when it affects the profit negatively, we attribute it as a loss. And when it affects profit positively, we attribute it as a gain. So how do we know the effect of these items? That is another thing. Now, apart from these seven mentioned items here that are supposed to reflect in the profit or loss appropriation, please, before you start preparing this account, the net profit carried down in the main body of the profit or loss account should be the first thing you bring down here. So you bring it down, then adjust for other profits and expenses before you now get to the profit that the partners will share, or the profit that is distributable to the partners individual, which is this number seven. Now look at interest on capital. Interest on capital, who contributed this capital? It is the partners that contributed this capital. Yes. Now, if there's any interest arising on top of this capital, who will pay the capital? It is the business that will pay this interest. In other words, since the business is paying this interest have a negative effect to the partnership, to the business. So the business is paying it. So that this one is a minus, it's a loss. it's going to be a loss. It's going to reduce the profit of the partnership. So what it means that interest on capital have a negative effect to the profit. Then number two is commission to a partner. Commission to a partner who is paying this commission is the partnership that is paying the commission. Maybe the partner performed a specific task and the partnership decided to pay the person commission. So it will affect the profit negatively. So this one is still another minus two that will affect the profit negatively. Then salaries to a partner. Who pays this salary to a partner? It is still the business that is paying the money. So these salaries to a partner still have a negative effect. A partner is paid a salary separately from normal salary when he pays more attention in business than other people. We call them active partners. So this one still have a negative effect to the partnership. Interest on drawings. Yes, drawings is one of the items that brings down the value of a firm. Drawings is when the owner of a business withdraws money or withdraws stock or goods for personal use. You take something that you are using to run the business or what you are selling, you just take it to consume it personally. You see, if you continue to do this, the business will run down. So, and the partnership normally have a policy to restrict partners from withdrawing goods from the partnership by attaching rates of interest to any drawings made by the partners to discourage partners from withdrawing. So if there's a product being sold for 5,000 and a partner want to withdraw that product, the rule there is that if he withdraws the product, that there will be an interest attached to it, which means if the partnership is reflecting that product in the partner's capital account, actually the product is 5,000, but the partner will not pay 5,000. They will reduce the person's capital with something that is above 5,000, depending on the interest. You now verify that interest on drawing that the partnership is gaining, because the partners are paying, because they are the people that withdraw. So this one is have a positive effect to the profit, which means it will increase the profit. Interest on loan to a partner. Interest on loan to a partner comes when a partnership borrow money from a partner. And if partnership borrows money from a partner, that means that the partnership will have to pay. No, sorry. Interest on loan to a partner. That's the partnership borrowed money to a partner. And if a partnership borrows money to a partner, the partner should pay interest on loan. And if the partner should pay interest on loan, that means the partner is paying to the business, to the partnership, which means it's going to have a positive effect when a partner pays interest to the business. It has a positive effect. Then interest on loan from a partner. In this case, the partnership borrowed money from a partner and thereby the partnership will pay interest. So in this case, what happens here is that this one have a negative effect to the profit. So with this, in the next video clip, we are going to split this, and you see how this account is being prepared. You see the format of this account and try to see the techniques, more techniques involved in preparing this account.